And I'm talking right now with Vanguard Group Chairman and CEO Bill McNabb. And Bill, you are stepping down as CEO next month after being in the job since 2008. You've done an incredible job parlaying your position as a low-cost investing pioneer to becoming one of the world's largest investment management companies with $4.5 trillion in global assets, more than 20 million investors worldwide. Tell us the track for the company going forward. As you step down, you're obviously a statesman in this industry. How do you want Vanguard to continue going forward?
Well, thanks, Maria. And first of all, just our hearts go out to everybody in New York. We know everybody is probably very fearful this morning based on the news, and we'll be thinking of everybody there. You know, as to Vanguard going forward, I am very optimistic about the future. We've got a great leadership team, and we're going to be focused on continuing to do what we've done, which is deliver really high value to our investors. So I think you can expect us to continue to push the idea of low-cost investing around the world, so not just in the U.S., but certainly globally. I think going forward, perhaps the biggest area that you're going to see change will be in the provision of advice. You know, 4 out of 5 investors take advice in one shape or form. And I think that area is, you know, we're in very early innings of that whole segment of the market being revitalized, if you will. We think there is lots of room for fees to come down, for services to expand, and for investors to get a better deal in when it comes to advice.
Well, I mean, the ETF market obviously has grown. You've got a lot of wannabes behind you. Now you've got Goldman Sachs, you've got JP Morgan, even the major banks now selling ETFs. How, I mean, obviously with more players, you're setting the tone in terms of price. When you cut fees, the whole industry follows. How do you make money as people race to the bottom in terms of fee structures?
Well, I think you're going to, you know, on the product side, you know, fees are getting to the point where you're almost at an asymptotic level where it's going to be harder to make more progress there. But there's still opportunities in certain segments, certainly. Look, we think the competition is great. You know, what's happening is investors everywhere are recognizing that paying more for investments does not get you a better result. You know, it's kind of counterintuitive when you consider your consumer experience in most other segments. And, you know, with other players coming into the market, it just means more investors are going to have an opportunity for higher value.
And you've been investing in IT-related automation. You mentioned advice earlier. Is it going to be automated? Do you think we'll see more fintech mergers?
Yeah, I do. I you know, I think the, you know, the so-called robo-advice advances have really reset the bar about what's possible. And you know, we've certainly been following fintech broadly and, you know, in the advice space in particular. And we think there's a ton of opportunity to use technology to enhance what people do. So it doesn't necessarily mean, you know, total replacement of the individual. I still think the human element can be incredibly important. But I think the combination of technology with people can lead to tremendous results at a more effective price for investors.
Where do you see the ETF market, let's say, in 10 years? I mean, we're seeing, obviously, the passive way to invest take market share from active, whether it's hedge funds or even mutual funds. Do you think the ETF market at some point becomes bigger than the mutual fund business?
I don't know if that, you know, that would take quite a bit of growth over the next decade for that to occur. But I do think, you know, we look at ETFs as just another form of mutual funds. You know, the structure is advantageous for some types of investors where, you know, the traditional fund structure is advantageous for others. What I do think is going to continue is, you know, the proliferation of ETFs. I think you'll see more on the active space there. And again, the whole idea of high cost to low cost is going to permeate everything. It's not going to be really just an active, passive debate. It's really going to be a high cost, low cost debate. And, you know, I think the part of the market that's going to really, in a sense, suffer are going to be high cost active funds.
That's a really good point, because we've actually also seen underperformance on the part of very expensive hedge funds in the last several years. So you have to ask yourself, what am I paying for?
That's absolutely correct.
Yeah.
And, you know, what we think you'll continue to see is, you know, price competition on both the active and the index side. And, you know, again, I'd point out that, you know, our own flows in active fixed income have been incredibly strong the last 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
And our team does a fantastic job, you know, on the active side there, but they do it at a very low price. And I think that's kind of, you know, predictive of what you're going to see more broadly in the marketplace.
Yeah, I love what you said. More expensive doesn't mean better advice. People need to understand that. Bill McNabb, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Congratulations on your incredible tenure at the Vanguard Group.
Thanks, Maria.
We'll see you soon, sir. Thank you.